Hi guys, this is Structures Explained, and in this video we'll be learning about types of supports used in beams and reaction produced in them on loading. First of all, let us understand what a reaction is. Let us consider a block of concrete lying on the ground. In this arrangement, the block is applying a force of mass times acceleration to the ground. In return, the ground applies equal and opposite force as per Newton's third law of motion. This force is called reaction. Now let us see various types of supports and reactions they generate when applied by force. First we will see a simple support. In this support, the structural member simply rests on an external frictionless surface. This kind of support allows rotation and horizontal movements but not vertical motion. Hence it produces only one reaction to the applied force, which is perpendicular and away from the surface. Next we will see roller support. This support has wheels on the bottom and a hinge to attach members in it. The surface can be horizontal, vertical, or sloped at any angle. While assuming this support in calculations, all surfaces and the hinge are assumed to be frictionless. This kind of support allows lateral movement and rotation but does not allow vertical motion. Hence, it produces a vertical reaction to the applied force. Value of moment will be zero at roller support as it allows rotation. A roller support is generally represented in mechanics in this way. This kind of support is found in large bridges, which allows thermal expansion and contraction of the bridge. Next comes pinned support. This support is fixed at bottom and has a hinge to attach members in it. The surface to which support is attached can be horizontal, vertical, or sloped at any angle. This kind of support allows only rotation and restricts horizontal and vertical movements. Hence, it produces two reactions to the applied force, one in horizontal direction and other in vertical direction. Value of the bending moment will be zero at pin support as it allows rotation. Pin support is generally represented in mechanics in this way. This kind of support is also found in bridges and trusses. So will the pin support or roller support always allow rotation? The answer is not necessarily. If the roller or pin support act as intermediate support in continuous beam, then it will resist the rotation. In this illustration, the continuous beam is loaded uniformly. Dashed lines show the deflected shape of the beam where end support allow rotation but middle support resists the rotation. And zero moment at the ends and some value of moment in the middle. Next we will see rigid or fixed support. This kind of support restricts any kind of motion, hence we will see all three reactions, which are horizontal reaction, vertical reaction, and a moment. This type of connection is used in concrete framed structure or, in this case, a cantilevered beam. They are represented as single line for structural members and a hatched vertical line for fixed support. That's it for this video guys. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, hit that like button. Comment below your thoughts or questions regarding this video. More such content will follow, so do subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for new videos. Also check out our social media pages, links to which are in the description. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.